making changes to the way Amala, the budget is formulated, implemented, and evaluated. This will ensure value for money, effectiveness, efficiency, and economy. It is about restructuring the process and co-management of the nation's budget system to improve its feasibility as a fiscal policy vehicle. By implication, therefore, budget reforms must have direct impact on the level of implementation, otherwise it would be unnecessary. So it is not enough to have or to implement the ZBB. It must be timely release, there should be timely release of the budget and strict compliance with implementation, just as it is important for government to improve its source of income to accommodate more needs of its citizenry. So we said it's not just enough to have or to implement the ZBB, but it is also very important that the budget is being passed at the right time so that it will accommodate the implementation and the achievement of the targets that have been set up. Now, the other aspect that we want to touch is the options we have for the economic recovery of our nation. Governments at all levels must strategize and work toward the success of attracting private investors. But you know, this is subject to some other things. There is no way you can attract foreign investors when the security situation is bad. So part of the responsibility of government for a recovery of any economy, it's important that we secure the economy. Let there be an improvement in terms of security. There should be ease of doing business, and there should be provision of one-shot policy for all government revenue collections. What you see so many agencies coming to collect money from you. Now, that discourages investment. People have money, but no one wants to give out the money for whatever reason, be it tax or levy or what have you. Therefore, government should devise a means of having a one shop that will collect all the revenues that are due for any investment to flow. There should be increase in investment in areas that will generate more revenue. This could be achieved by developing initiatives that will bring business opportunities and provide required and needed services that people can appreciate. Now, the moment you continue to spend on things that will not bring money, there is no way you can think that you will improve on your collection. Part of your spending is supposed to be an encouragement of investment so that it will generate more income. You will have more platform to tax rather than spending on consumables that at the end of it will not generate any income. Another very important issue is the issue of data. It is only Lagos and some other few states that have generated enough data of the taxpayers. When you compare with other states, you don't know even who is to pay what, not to talk of pursuing them to pay what is due from them. So the first thing to do is to actually know who are your taxpayers. How many are they? What are their dues? That is the beginning of the whole thing. And the most disturbing issue is in the area of personal income tax. when you look at the amount generated based on personal income tax, you find out that pay as you go generates 95% of the total income, while only 5% is being generated from the informal sector. People like our directors and some of our professors here certainly evade tax. I'm sure the speaker will come part of this huge evidence of tax, because when you look at your income, when you ask any professor now to bring tax clearance certificate, he will go to BASA and collect tax clearance information from what they deduct from him as paid. While the huge investment that they make is more than what they are moving as their pay as you go. So there is a need to actually harmonize on data and know the capacities of taxpayers. Many of them dress as if they don't have anything. But when you look at the jump of assets under their names, you tend to be surprised. No, bro, I'm not taking this. So there is, and when you look at the population, you find out that only less than 20% are on the employment of government. So if you rely on PAYE, you find if PAYE was good 95%, what of the jump of 80% of the population that generate income? If you really harmonize the issue or articulate the issue of informal sector, definitely you would realize a lot of funds from here. Among other options for the recovery of the economy, there is the need to reduce the cost of governance. This will help to reduce government spending to the desired level of the nation's income generating capacity that has shrunk. Hence, we need to reduce government spending, especially in terms of running costs. We said spend on issues that will generate more revenue. Further to this, there should be a comprehensive look at government policies that will ensure continued progress in terms of strategies that will ensure continued growth in various sectors of the economy. The policies must ensure that investors are comfortable, secure, and attracted to various investment opportunities. Improve programs that ensure youth empowerment and poverty reduction, and which encourage self-development and entrepreneurial skills development among graduates. But when a government makes policies and another government